Hello everyone, welcome back to Learn Electronics with Associated by ProfEC.com. Here is the simplest way to understand the energy band diagram. Valence band exhibit electrons in the outer orbit that would be available for the conduction with respect to other measurements. What is actual energy value of the valence band? There is nothing like that. Yeah, definitely. As per the atoms and its impurities, the higher and lower energy values of the valence band is determined. As we know, every material has its own energy. For the standard measure, negotiating the accurate energy value completely, just focusing on complete band. Conduction band denoting electrons which is in and making conduction. The energy of conduction electron is exhibit in conduction band. Based on conducting properties of materials, energy band diagram was drawn for the three fundamental categories of materials. Type 1. In this category of materials, don't have electrons for conduction in room temperature, even though applying larger voltage across this type of material and still valence electron didn't get the energy of the conduction band. Thanks to those electrons, atoms are fulfilled orbits which is tightly connected with their nuclei. The force between nucleus and respective electrons of its own atom are tremendous, practically hard to break that. To be exactly, there is no chance at all. Applying more energy to break will burn the material completely because it definitely disturbs the nucleus itself. This kind of closed atom structure materials are called as insulator. Energy gap between valence and conduction is enormous and unachievable too. So this kind of materials are not useful for our electronics. Type 2. This kind of materials have few electrons for conduction in room temperature. Furtherly, current injection through the material will increase the current at considerable range. This kind of material have spare electrons or holes in for most orbit, which will do the conducting part. Basically, outermost orbit electrons have covalent bonding with the neighboring atoms and impurities. Covalent bonds are easily get break for tiny changes in temperature and smaller value of currents. Whenever temperature increases, the covalent bond will break, few electrons escape from the orbit and free to move across the material. In other words, covalent bond will break if temperature increases. Valence electrons get higher energy and reach the conduction band energy level and ready to make current conduct. Then type 3. At room temperature, this material having tons of electrons for conduction. Further increase in temperature will create electron tsunami itself. This material having lot of electrons in outer orbit without much attraction force with nucleus. Due to minimum attachment with nucleus, no much pressure is needed for electrons to escape from the orbit. Literally nothing needed. That gives that valence band electrons already having conduction band's energy without any assistance. Drawing the energy band diagram for this kind of materials are really simple. Valence and conduction bands are overridden. This kind of materials are called as conductors. I strongly believe that this energy diagram explanation gives you much more deeper insights. You can digitally upload this content by doing like, dislike, comment and share. Thanks for learning. See you on the flip side. Love you all, electrons. Bye-bye.